Welcome to Lecture Online. In the previous video, we had a pretty good idea that the reason why there was such a large variation in the diurnal temperature range, anywhere from just a few centigrade degrees to as much as almost 30 centigrade degrees, was the amount of water vapor in the atmosphere. It was the primary reason why the amount of heat moved from the lower troposphere into the higher troposphere would be increased or decreased, primarily because of the water vapor in the atmosphere. And so what we're going to do here is show you a table and a graph that exemplifies the differences in the diurnal temperature range due to the various amount of water vapor in the atmosphere. Let's say that at 30 degrees centigrade, we want to have a relative humidity going anywhere from 100% to 30%, which means we can then calculate the partial vapor pressure. Well, they've already done that for us, so we simply listed the partial vapor pressure at the various relative humidities for an air temperature of 30 degrees centigrade. Of course, for different temperatures, that would be a different number. We're measuring the partial, and I think I'm missing a T in this word here, so partial vapor pressure is going to be measured in millimeters of mercury. Notice that the atmospheric pressure is about 760 mercuries of pressure. So this is what we call the partial vapor pressure of the amount of water vapor in the atmosphere for these various relative humidities at a temperature, the air temperature of 30 degrees centigrade. Converting that in percentage of water vapor for the total atmosphere, notice that at 100% humidity with a temperature of 30 degrees centigrade, which is about 86 degrees Fahrenheit, we have as much as 5.6% of the atmosphere being water vapor. At 90%, that drops down to 5%. At 80%, that drops down to 4.5%. At 70%, drops down to 3.9%, and so forth. So you can imagine that if water vapor is an important greenhouse gas, and it is, it's the most important, and there's very large variations in the concentration of the water vapor, that should have a very, very big effect on how fast energy or heat can move from the lower troposphere towards the higher troposphere, which means the ability to keep in the heat is what's going to control how warm it's going to be in the lower troposphere. If we now take a look at this graph right here, notice again we have the relative humidity from 100% to 90 to 80 to 70, 60, and so forth. And at 30 degrees centigrade, we have the corresponding what we call diurnal temperature range, the difference in the temperature from the high to the low in a particular location. Now notice that it's sometimes difficult to ascertain. So there are factors that do affect that, which have really nothing to do with the relative humidity and with the amount of water vapor in the atmosphere. Factors such as winds, cloud cover, large masses of air moving around, which can cause tremendous temperature differences not related to these factors. But if we can somehow separate the diurnal effect because of the difference in the water vapor in the atmosphere from all the others, we can pretty well say that there's a large difference in the temperature difference between day and night, depending upon how much water vapor we have in the atmosphere. Notice at 100% humidity, with a temperature of 30 degrees centigrade, the difference between day and night is roughly about 10 centigrade degrees. But if we drop down to a relative humidity of 30%, and notice instead of having 5.6% water vapor, down to 1.7% water vapor, notice that the temperature difference between day and night increases to 22%, which means much more energy moves from the lower troposphere into the higher troposphere, cooling down the surface quite a bit. So you can see that that air movement, or not the air movement, but the energy movement from the lower to the higher troposphere is very much controlled and affected by the amount of water vapor in the atmosphere. You can imagine as we then go to lower and lower concentrations, you can see the shape of the curve, the difference becomes larger and larger and larger, and we'll take another look at that in some future videos. But you can see that this is one of the biggest, if not, well, probably the biggest effect in the difference in the temperature and in the ability for the atmosphere to move heat from the lower troposphere to the higher troposphere. Notice also that we've measured that in summer, the diurnal temperature range is smaller than it is in wintertime, which makes a lot of sense because in summer, the air tends to be a lot more moist, there tends to be a lot more water vapor in the atmosphere, and therefore in summer, the difference between day and night is much smaller. In the wintertime, especially in the desert regions, where the relative humidity gets very, very small because a lot of the moisture comes out of the atmosphere, in the wintertime, The difference in the temperature range can be enormous, and we've seen places in the deserts where the difference between day and nighttime can be as much as 50 Fahrenheit degrees, or about 30 centigrade degrees. So you can see it does make an enormous difference. Water vapor is the one that keeps us warm primarily, and you can see that by these graphs and these results. And that's how it works.